Hello, I'm Shuni from MSK MRI.
The medial side of the knee can be divided into anterior, middle, and posterior thirds. The anterior third extends from the medial border of the patellar tendon to the anterior border of the longitudinal fibers of the superficial medial collateral ligament. The middle third is composed of the width of these longitudinal fibers of the medial collateral ligament. Let's examine the medial aspect of the knee, where the superficial medial collateral ligament is highlighted in red, the meniscofemoral ligament is aqua, and the meniscotibial ligament is green. The posterior third encompasses the posteromedial corner of the knee, lying between the posterior margin of the superficial medial collateral ligament and the medial border of the posterior cruciate ligament. Injuries to the posteromedial corner are crucial to recognize, as they can cause anteromedial rotational instability. The posteromedial corner is a primary stabilizer against valgus laxity and a secondary stabilizer against anterior tibial translation and external rotation. Anteromedial rotational instability is the hallmark of posteromedial corner injuries. The posteromedial corner has five major components: the semimembranosus tendon and its expansions, the oblique popliteal ligament, the posterior oblique ligament, the posteromedial joint capsule, and the posterior horn of the medial meniscus. Focusing on the posteromedial corner, we observe the semimembranosus tendon and its direct and anterior arms, the oblique popliteal ligament is highlighted in yellow. The semimembranosus tendon and its expansions are shown in purple. The posterior oblique ligament is highlighted in orange. Future video presentations will provide detailed information on each of these components. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like it,